Welcome back to the stream. Welcome back to the stream. Everybody, welcome back to the stream. Let's go. Welcome everybody, we are live. You are tuned in to Saturday Slugfest. And we don't have four matches tonight. We got an Extra Stuff 6 match card on deck coming to you live from Orlando, Florida tonight, as we are getting underway for the March Madness edition this month, with all these tournaments going on leading to all the finals matchups. At No Gimmicks, we're kicking things off with a first-time one-on-one matchup. It's Bulldozer taking on KU. The winner of this match will meet Hip Hop Joe in the semifinals. This one should be a banger. Big clash in styles, the powerhouse, and Bulldozer, former WWA World Champion, by the way, taking on star that's been on the rise for quite some time in KU, a big fan favorite amongst the WWA universe, and he's looking to break out here tonight on Slugfest. Let's get it. Big Bully Bulldozers in the building, ready for this first round matchup against KU. Looking to put himself back on that championship path and make a better reign the second time around. But he's got to go through three opponents in order to do so.
All right, I love this guy.
Straight out the fucking dungeon of rap, BK all day, this is KU.
The WWE Universe delivering quite a reaction, perhaps the most highly anticipated match of the night.
Love, Noah.
Competitor with his
this
share
is the second half of the brackets for the world title contender tournament, the women's world title, and I believe the men's intercontinental. Next week is going to be the tag team on both ends plus the women's IC. No, not tonight. You won't be on the card till week 43. This is week 41, part 2. Because once the first round matchups are all the way out of there, there'll be more room for other matches on the show. But you can stay tuned in to see who's going to be taking on Rodney. That match is tonight.
And here we have a superstar with a big
I think he got
shoulder.
The winner of Flash and Connor.
Well, he has a chance we'll to see. Change that perception in this matchup. But he'll be facing off against someone who is
Let me check my brackets while I'm here, while this match kicks off. Someone Bulldozer on the offense early. Really giving it to KU.
Big punch finds its mark.
KU trying to fight back, opening them up with those chops and punches to the chest. Nailing that nasty palm strike to the chin as Bulldozer fights right out of it, slams him into the corner.
He saw it coming.
Yeah, Rodney's got the winner of he's got the winner of Flash Bear. Rebel and Connor. So that's shot. Tonight.
Boom.
Then you got Jared and Chris Cole. That's gonna be nasty. Casey and Collins, that's a big one.
Ooh, harsh kick.
So it's gonna be interesting.
Knife edge chop.
KU, my guy's facing the winner of this match on week 43. So
yes,
I gotta watch this match closely. I've beaten Bulldozer before. It took a lot out of me, but I beat him. Well, I take the back. We beat him in a. I pinned him in a tag team match, a tornado tag. I don't think I've gone with him straight up one on one though. As Bulldozer sends KU crashing to the mat off the top rope. He gets caught with that kick to the face. Right on top of the skull. Oh, and he breaks him down, leveling him with that DDT into the mat. After a nasty strike combo, but only got a one count.
Change something up with the pin technique.
KU sizing up the bully. Got his hands up, went for that chop, but it was kicked away. And now Bulldozer setting him up for that trifecta with those short arm clotheslines, looking for the hat trick. Absolutely nails it and goes for the cover. One. Not even a two.
He's not letting fatigue set in or
match
get the better.
Bulldozer not letting his focus slip here tonight. If he has been locked in since the bell is rung, there's a big splash.
Could be in search of a
KU getting
now.
That shoulder up.
Ooh, stinging kick.
But he's got to get back on his feet as Bulldozer is absolutely abusing this man here tonight.
Talk about dismantling your opponent. He's able to sidestep.
Back on his feet, tried to go for the chop block, momentarily stunning the bully, and there's a big neck breaker. Took him right off his feet. KU.
Reversal. Can they
even call it that
attack?
Knee to the gut. And his Bulldozer was putting him in that fireman's
right
carry.
Now, just carried like a rag doll here.
Snake eyeing him right on that top rope. Oof.
Makes him pay with
kicks back though. Slamming his head multiple times in the mat, looking for the concussion. And now he's got that sleeper locked in, doubling down on the head attacks here. Trying to cut off that airway. Making it that much tighter for him to breathe. And Bulldozer finds an opening, hitting those elbows to the face. Pulling KU by the throat. What's he thinking here? Big haymaker to the gut. Knocking the wind right out of him. That vicious headbutt followed up by that arm slam. And Bulldozer, seeing red, trying to bust KU open the hard way. Shit, my eyes are red. This is crazy. Goes for the cover. Almost got a three count. Shocking.
By the skin of his teeth. Oh god, that hurt.
And he goes back to work on that arm. KU worse for wear at the moment. Really needs to get some offense in. And he's been playing defense the majority of this match. Look for another haymaker. KU had it scouted. Big clothesline from hell took him down out of nowhere. Is it enough? One, two. Oh, Bulldozer never saw it coming, and KU is right back in this match. He's got him up. Oh, he set him up for that patented pile driver. Oh, he gets back body drops right out of it. Jesus. Bulldozer. KU by the neck. Looking for that patented inverted Alabama slam. No. Gets him off the ropes and drops him right on his face. That'll do it. There's the cover. One, two, three.
Man, that has got to feel good. Sweet, sweet victory.
Your winner, moving on to the second round, Big Bad Bully Bulldozer, getting the Heat's win over KU here tonight.
Gas prices are high and I'm diesel, you can't afford me. Lord, he prayed that you giving them cap competition. How the shit in the streets and the sheets of my competition. See me and Chains cut the chains loose on the pit bulls. Fighting and biting at your niggas till they get bulls. Already dropping the gauge out the window.
Like
shooting out niggas tires and laughing and smoking endo.
Like
see, I raised the bar.
This
the opposite of the limbo. Only thing left to do is go
he's
and get a piece of tempo.
Put them
easy,
to use
I do this. I'm Christ, you the Judas. Letting my nuts sang like
congratulations for getting the bulldozer on his first round win. We're about to move on to the next contest of the night. It's gonna be Flash Rebel taking on his longtime rival Connor in this one-on-one first round matchup for the Intercontinental Championship Contenders Tournament. The winner will move on to face Rodney That Dude on week 43. Let's get into it. Pull up, hop out, Flash Rebel is here.
The following contest is scheduled.
He's looking for a fight here on Slugfest. Ready to take down his arch nemesis, Connor, the Supreme Suplex Machine himself. Both these men know each other very well, which should make for a very entertaining open first round matchup. Win here will put Ivan Man on a path closer to the Intercontinental Championship. Whether it be JXM, potentially Ricky Rush, only time will tell.
A competitor who does not know the meaning of the word quit. He is ready
but
for
the
battle.
Crowd loving them some Flash Rebel here tonight. You already know what time it is, baby. We're gonna rock out with our cocks out. The Supreme Suplex Machine Connor is here.
And his opponent from Aurora, Colorado, weighing in at 186 pounds, Connor.
You are looking at some highly motivated competitors in this match, looking to steal the show and capture the attention of the entire WWE Universe.
He said he'll be making a statement in this match tonight and will deliver it emphatically.
All right, Flash Rebel, Connor. Tournament action on Slugfest, ring that bell.
You sense the anger emanating from the competitor tonight.
Connor tries to come out swinging.
This is a man you don't want to
see. Sending Flash into the corner early.
He's a man possessed is what he is.
But across the way is a man
off the middle rope, big kick to the face, took him right off his feet.
Extra time training and scouting for his competition.
Kamigoye knee strike to the face.
Standing shooting star press.
Connor's on the offense early, getting several strikes in as he lands that standing shooting star. Only got a two count. Flash Rebel not looking so hot, but it is early in this contest. And as I speak it, he nails it, hitting that elevated flatliner. As Flash looks to turn this match around, Connor giving him that boot to the face will have none of it. Went for a blockbuster. There was no one there at all. Connor was sent off the ropes, and Flash was not prepared for him to come back so early. And now he's making him pay for it.
Oh, atomic drop into an up kick to the face.
Big knee to the elbow.
Oh!
Connor making sure the feet find their mark as he lands that kick to the spine. You gotta wonder how much damage he's really doing with that protective padding all over him.
Carefully measured knee strikes.
Well, I don't think he can take too many more knees to the head. Connor's got a game plan here tonight. He's been dissecting Flash since the bell has rung. Flash trying to fight back down as he puts him on the apron.
Well scattered reversal.
It was a huge forearm. Connor with the slingshot drop kick, finding his mark right on the chin.
Seems like he can't be stopped.
Connor is definitely in control of this match.
Just broken something.
The way this match is paced, and we're definitely going to be seeing Connor versus Rodney that dude in a couple weeks on Throwdown. Or will we?
Uh-oh.
As he comes off the top, big diving foot stomp to the stomach.
Into the cover.
Connor with the cover.
And he kicks out at two.
Flash fighting the wherewithal to get his shoulders up as he kicks out. Connor's looking to bring him to his feet. Went for that high kick. Flash had a scout and nails a kick of his own. Now Flash sending Connor to the corner. Locks him up. Has him by the shoulders. Hoists him up. He's going to long dart him right into the middle turnbuckle.
He may get the three count right here.
Flash looking for a cover. One, two.
No. This is no time to hesitate. You can feel
it's not time. Not just yet. Flash has to go right back to the attack. Nailing that stomp to the right elbow. He's looking for some middle rope action. What a diving headbutt. The rare aerial assault coming from Flash Rebel here tonight. As he tried to put him on his feet, got caught with a dragon screw counter takedown.
Oh, costly error there.
But he rolls out of the way of that springboard moonsault. Flash, right back in the game, nails him with that released German suplex.
He's lost some of his win now.
Flash, deadlifts this man. The tossing suplex right over his shoulders.
Dropping the elbow. He's just getting thrown around out here.
Yeah, and every attempt to fight back's being negated.
Turning the tables there. He skirts around it.
Both men on their feet. He went for that high knee. And Connor tried to do a slingshot move off that turnbuckle. Flash cut him off. And now he's got him backed up in a corner. Connor fighting out with the elbow. He's looking for that flatliner. Finds its mark, drops him face first. Here we go. Connor putting Flash on his feet. Big chops to the chest, kick to the knee. The combo doing much damage. Hits the middle rope. There's another kick to the face. Turns him inside out with the disaster kick. What a close two count. Two and three fourths. And Connor's ready to put this one away. He was looking for that brainbuster Falcon Arrow-like maneuver, but Flash will not have none of it tonight. Has Connor right back on his feet. And he nails the deep six slam.
This is it.
Is it enough to put him away? One, two, no.
He just won't.
Connor's still in this one. This Flash is going to have to do just a little bit more to put him away here tonight. Looks for the gun stud. Absolutely drops him on his face. Is that enough? One, two.
Ugh.
Connor got the shoulder up. Flash can't believe it. Neither can this crowd. This match is getting intense. What does Rebel got to do to put this man away as he ascends to the middle rope? Another diving headbutt.
He may be in a bad
goes for the cover.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that.
And Connor getting the shoulder up once again. Flash is beside himself. Clawing at his face. There's a punch to the gut. Faked him out with a chop, and he drops him with the DDT. Bottom rope moonsault finding its mark. There's another cover.
Still only got one.
It's Flash getting the shoulder up this time. Flash fights right out of it. Catching Connor with another deadlift tossing suplex.
What impact!
Make that three. Oh, deadlift powerbomb. What a knee to the skull.
And the electricity of this moment is coursing through his veins.
Connor.
And
Takedown flash again. Standing shooting star. And this might be over soon. Connor looking to put this man away. There's a springboard forearm right off the corner turnbuckle. Another cover. One, two, no. Flash got the shoulder up and Connor can't believe it. He's on the top rope. Is he looking for that patented frog splash up and down? One, two, no. Flash got the shoulder up again. Connor can't believe it. What an opening round match this is. A standing shooting star. That might do it. And Flash continues to dig down deep, pulling out the reserves here tonight. Bottom rope moonsault. Connor with the desperation cover. One, two. And Flash got the shoulder up again. Wow. And Connor's trying to break this man's arm live on television. Heading to the top rope once again. Flash has not been able to get back on his feet. Connor's forcing him to do it. Waits for him to stand up. Tight rope walk. There's a dropkick. Flash had it scouted.
He isn't allowing that burst of attacks to finish him.
Sends him off the ropes. Went for the back elbow, but mistimed it. Flash trying to fight back, but gets caught with those strikes. Judo takedown. Sends him Connor on his back. Flash setting up Connor. Deep six slam.
Here he goes for the win.
Here comes the cover. And Connor got the shoulder up. Flash is beside himself. What an opening first round matchup this is. Waist deep slam. Slamming him right on his back. Flash ready to end it here. Sends him off the ropes and he's got him on the apron, folks. Big stun gun. Sends him to the floor. Flash is ready to risk it all to advance to the second round. He's got Connor on the outside. Huge diving forearm to the face. Absolutely finds his mark and Flash is fully in control of this contest. Connor still trying to fight back. Dropping Flash with the flatliner on the floor. This match is heated. Nailing that strike combo on the outside. It's not looking good for Flash out here, bro. Sends him into the barricade. What is he waiting for? Went for the clothesline and now he's stunned. Dropped him with a DDT. Wow. Connor's got this man gushing blood on the outside. He's looking like Ric Flair in his prime.
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
What a kick. We are not having that tonight. Not as good as this match has been. No, sir. We got to break this count. There we go.
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring.
Both men back on the feet. Oh, Flash with a big kick to the face.
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Ah, flipping the script on him there.
Reciprocating the initial reversal.
On the outside, a huge powerbomb. Jesus. Excuse me. Flash rolling back in the ring, looking to bring the action to the inside. As we wait for Connor to get to his feet. Flash breaking the count.
He's taking this to the floor now.
There's some power behind that punch.
He's setting up Flash on the floor. Walks him to the apron. Oh no. Drives him spine first on the apron. Swings him right into it. Ugh. Connor's body's got to be thriving in pain right now. Flash should be able to put this one away right here. Turns over Connor. He's looking for the pinfall.
No, didn't get it.
Connor's still in the game. Wow.
Moving at this point is beyond the realm of reality.
Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near.
Flash is looking for it. Went for the gun stun. Connor had it scattered. There's a claymore to the face. One, two. And Flash got the shoulder up again. What's it going to take to put him away?
And his eyes are piercing through the opposition now.
Flash on his feet. Connor. Nailing that Connor's cure slam.
Boom! Planet.
That was impressive.
Will he
be able to
capitalize? One, two, three. Finally, monumental victory.
What a match. RTD, watch out. Connor is coming.
The matches of the year. Let's take another look at some of the action.
Oh, you peeps? Man, that was a nasty match.
Guys, it's rare we see such a closely contested match.
I don't care if it's Flash ain't used his resiliency at the end. That would have made it even more epic.
Even having your name called in your
own. That was good. That was real good. Up next, we got some women's action on deck. Congratulations to Connor. In this first round matchup for the Women's Championship Contenders Tournament, it's Kerry Marie taking on Jackie Rivera, a newcomer to the world title division. She missed the mark in that four-way for that title shot at Tough Love. But she's looking to bounce back in a big way here tonight against the Cat, Kerry Marie. Winner of this match will be taking on Big Nasty Bertha. So congrats, I guess. But it's time for the matchup. Kerry Marie, Jackie Rivera, let's get it.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, what horse?
The high horse this superstar always seems to be on.
Did Jerry Lawler write that line for you?
The Cat, Kerry Marie, looking to get back on that path to gold as we await the arrival of Jackie Rivera. Rivera in charge, the oldest sister of the clan. This is Jackie Rivera coming at you live on Saturday Slugfest. Looking to pick up the big dub here tonight. The former three-time WWA Women's Intercontinental Champion. Moving on to bigger and better things here tonight. Looking to advance to the second round in a potential first-time matchup with Bertha. Prayers for the winner.
Laser-focused on the competition. I expect big things from her tonight.
The Cat, Jackie, one-on-one, first round matchup, let's get it.
And coming into this matchup, there has been a fire burning.
Jackie opened up with those jabs early.
Well, she certainly has
those educated fists going to work.
Lightly, angry at the disrespect
she drops her with that vertical suplex.
That all said, she's facing off against
taking it to the sky early. Jackie has not let up on the Cat one bit. First it was the springboard moonsault, followed up by that elbow drop, and the Cat is down bad early.
Once again,
Jackie coming out super aggressive.
What a counter!
as the cat elbows her way out of that chin lock.
She sent to the outside.
She sends Jackie flying to the floor.
She heads out of the ring, but she Carrie needs Marie to pay on the attention outside. To the count.
Drops her with that judo DDT.
Now trampling the opposition. Measured knee drop.
Follows it up with a knee to the face. The action coming in rapid on the floor.
It's the drop kick.
As Karen Marie plants that drop kick on the chin of Jackie. Oh God, scissor rips first into the stairs. Karen Marie showing an aggressive side here tonight.
She's getting fired up, ready to show her opponent what she's got.
Playing up to the crowd as we wait on Jackie to get to her feet.
She's in danger.
She's slow to get back up, but she is back up. What was the cat looking for over there?
Crash decision making there proved to be extremely detrimental.
And Vera starts to fire back now.
You have to wonder.
Getting a little mini strike combo in.
Powerless position.
And she hoists Carrie up on her shoulders, dropping her on that barricade face first. The crowd in the front row loving what they're seeing. Especially the young man in that teal green shirt.
Let's go. Bring it.
Oh, what
Jackie.
A right hook.
Huge hook to the face. Has her up and down with the running power slam.
Looking bad for her here.
She's going to work.
Relentless.
Enough already.
I want Jackie to get this win just so I can see her versus Bertha, but I don't know.
It could change the course of the match.
It's always a foregone conclusion it'll Bertha match to me, no matter who, what you throw at her. Unless it's Andreata. But Jackie nailing that elbow off the top as the cat got the shoulder up. Watch out, ref. She was looking to go to the top rope, but the referee got in the way and made her rethink her decision as the cat hits that springboard rope through head scissors, taking Rivera right off her feet. Flying back with that kick. That standing shooting star. Followed up. Made its mark. And now she's targeting that left arm. Carrie serving back those strikes in a furious fashion. But Jackie got the hands up. But ends up getting caught with that running bulldog. That face crusher, if you will. And it's all now it's Carrie Marie's turn to inflict the pain.
Yeah, and she is taking all the restraints.
Feeds off the energy of the crowd. She nails another standing shooting star into the chest.
And now she's climbing to the top.
The cat going to the top. Looking to reach up for the skies with that moonsault. Got the knees up. Excuse me. Jackie. Fist to the face. Another one. Kick to the gut. She set up for that sunset flip. Catches her with the roll through. Doesn't go for the pin. Does now. Could have stayed in it.
Strong kick out there.
There's a shoulder up from Carrie.
Simple kick out.
You know what Jackie's thinking. Looking for that strong Uranagi. She's got to be.
Placing them into the corner.
Has the cat in the corner. Look at this elbow combo. Quick combo took her down. And she's looking for that moonsault. Best moonsault ever. One. Two. No.
That was a long two count there.
Carrie thought she had escaped danger, but Jackie had other plans for her. And she's looking for that Harlem hangover right off the top rope. No. Crashes and burns. And now Carrie's looking to capitalize, but Jackie fighting right back. She'll have none of it. Raking the face, gouging that eye, giving her a surprise elbow to the face. Just mangling her with those punches.
Barrage. And the momentum's clearly gotten away from her now. Yeah, she's being met with a roadblock every time.
She's got the cat in the corner. Look for that jab. Carrie had it scouted. Here we go.
Get back into this match.
Got Jackie in that headlock looking for that running patented bulldog.
Brings them down.
Planting her face first.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth.
What a kick back to the face. Here comes Jackie. Send him for that fisherman suplex. In these first round matches, they have been highly competitive. She only gets the two count. Carrie dug down deep for that left shoulder up. And Jackie's right back to the drawing board here tonight.
Enough already.
Jackie Rivera with a very strike-based moveset, if I do say so myself.
This is just ruthlessness personified. Just brutalizing her opponent here.
She's headed to the top rope. She wants her on her feet. What's she thinking?
Look out!
Went for the missile dropkick, missed his mark. But the right hook definitely found her face.
She's got the shoulders down.
And that'll do it.
It's finally over.
Jackie Rivera shocking everybody with that final maneuver. As she picks up the win and advances on to the second round, she'll be facing Big Nasty Bertha.
Respect to both competitors. And this I love. This I absolutely love. Maybe you should have taken a page out of that kid's book in your career, Corey. Great sportsmanship.
Your winner, the head Rivera in charge, Jackie Rivera. Congrats again to the oldest sister of the crew as we move on to some more men's action here tonight. Going to be Jarrett taking on newcomer Chris Cole in the Intercontinental Championship Contenders Tournament. The winner of this match will move on to the semifinals to take on Lunchbox. Should be an interesting matchup nonetheless. Definitely a first time one around here. As Jarrett, who's been on the radar for a while, looking to get back on that path to gold here tonight. As he is a former Intercontinental Champion himself before he ultimately dropped it back to his cousin, Casey Heenan. Which would start the beginning of his second reign, which lasted roughly 80 days and then change before he dropped it to Young Bundy. Let's get it.
Members of the WWE Universe in attendance, they are all here because of matches like this one.
Here we go. The lunatic Chris Cole has entered the Saturday Slugfest building, ready to take on Jarrett in this opening first round contest. How to
think six. I can't watch this entrance. I heard this one backstage.
I dig those tattoos.
Why don't they get in the ring?
They're everywhere, but they're all
right. That's what they're doing right now, Corey. Well, good. Let's see what they've got then.
No.
Oh.
He has a big match ahead of him. Going to need a career-making performance here tonight.
Chris Cole ready to make a statement at Jarrett's expense in this first round match. Surveying this crowd. It's a shitload of logos, though. Ugh.
And here's a superstar. Here we go. That has all the tools.
Cole locking up Jarrett early. Taking him down with that double underhook powerbomb. Jesus.
Oh no, getting in position.
I got a tattoo saved on my phone right now, but it's got person skin on it, so I don't know how it'll look on me. Fire though. Ooh, went for the chop, but he had it scouted. Jarrett trying to fire back. And these men are throwing haymakers early. Oh, the big chop sent them flying. What a back fist.
He's got him down. Is this it?
There's a cover.
And he powers out.
Jarrett got the shoulder up. Cole definitely got the momentum in his corner early. That flurry of strikes really paying off here early in this contest. As Jarrett's back on his feet, went for the high single leg drop kick, got none of it. And Cole takes him down with a spine buster.
Able to interrupt the attack.
Shoves off Cole.
And
Jarrett's trying to fight back.
Unbelievable.
He's trying to rip this man open by the mouth. Very villain style, if you ask me.
Stump puller leg snap. Very effective.
What a leg breaker from Jarrett. Nice target into the left arm, too. Ugh. Doubling down. Has Cole on his feet. Setting him up for that fisherman's DDT. That cradle, that package driver right into a pinfall. Hooked the leg and only got a two count.
Couldn't quite slam the door yet. It's a rather crude.
Ooh, yeah, your boy on commentary is definitely feeling it.
That's not right.
And he is now. Man's gonna get a whole nap in after this show's over.
He deflects it right back.
That round kick to the gut. Jarrett's starting to get back to his feet. Cole went for it all that haymaker, but Jarrett got the duck counter. And now he's fighting back with a combo of his own. Took him down with the drop kick. Nap, sleep, whatever it's supposed to be. I know my eyes are going to be shut. Shit, I just woke up at 8 o'clock. What you mean? That boy had me up all day today. I was like, Juju, go to bed. Oh, my God. Schoolboy right into a super kick. Not at all. Vacay ended Sunday, but I was off Monday for Raw. Middle rope, Phoenix Splash finds its mark. Oh, snap. One, two.
Very close.
Oh, I got to send you something anyway while I'm sitting there thinking about it. As Jarrett hits that ripcord knee. Jesus. Let me do it after the match, just in case this thing ends early, because Jarrett's looking to kill this man live on Saturday Slugfest. No, it's Juju's birthday party thing. Chuck E. Cheese. That was a last resort. More on that later. Oh, God. Leg drape DDT. That's evil. I love that move.
Here he goes for the win.
One, two.
Oh, and
Jarrett got the shoulder up.
Turn out the light.
Chris Cole can't believe it as the blood pours down from his face. He's going to resort to more drastic measures. Ugh.
Meet him at the pay window.
That Omega Crush definitely doing the job.
Perhaps worth it now.
Wow.
No doubt it was a good one. Here's another look.
And Chris Cole will move on to the next round to take on Lunchbox in this IC title contenders tournament.
Here is your winner, the Lunatic, Chris Cole. This is the type of victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
This victory is exactly the kind of statement I knew we wanted to make here.
This was a message from him to the entire WWE Universe.
Congratulations again to Chris Cole as we move on to the next contest of the night. Pause, damn it. There we go. Ugh. It's Casey Heenan taking on Brandon Collins, who's going to be accompanied by Connor and Sonya Cruz. Okay. This is fine. This will be a very interesting first round matchup. Casey Heenan and Collins locking up for the first time that I can think of in a one-on-one. The winner will move on to take on Caleb Rivera in the semifinals of the World Championship Contenders Tournament. Should be interesting nonetheless. Let's get into it. Because they take forever. I'm not gonna hold you. This mixed tag matches, boy. Whoa. Making his way to the ring from New York. Weighing in at 100. But I can definitely do a couple. But I'm not gonna do a whole division of it, though.
Guys, this match has the potential to completely change the WWE landscape.
Shit, tag matches in general take forever. But those mixed tags, they take even longer.
Doesn't matter where.
So I just treat those as like special attractions for right now. But the villain Casey Heenan recently moved over to the world title division, and he's ready to make his mark here tonight. Here we go.
We are about to see something good.
No need to adjust your screen. Speedy E. Wrestling live on stream. Speedy E.
Weighing in at 222 pounds. Brandon Collins. A matchup like this, it's one that the locker room has wanted to see. It's one that the WWE Universe has wanted to see. It's one that I've been waiting to see. And it's about to go down. He says it's all about dominance tonight and plans on showing why everyone backstage should be scared.
Mr. BDE Brandon Collins, former two-time WWA champion, looking to put himself on the road to becoming a three-time champ. And that road starts here tonight in this one-on-one contest with Casey Heenan. Casey Collins, here we go.
He's a superstar that has all the tools to be one of the biggest names this business has ever seen.
Casey taking down Collins early with that springboard forearm. But his performance in this match, looking to get some middle rope action. Changes his mind as Collins has got back to his feet a little quicker than expected. The villain putting him in a corner, nailing those multiple knees to the chest. Really working over that rib area as he's putting the boots to the face. Hits the rope with a full steam, and there's a big fucking kick to the face. Collins now back on his feet. He was being held by the neck, but elbowed his way out, and he's looking to strike his way back into this match. Laying in those knees to the ribs. Enough to bring the villain down to the mat. As he shows off the athleticism with that handstand headlock. He set him up for that modified clutch. Locking the arm between the legs and choking him out at a very vicious angle. Casey snapmares his way out. These two are right back at square one. Villain. Tried to send him to the floor. Collins would have none of it. And now he's got him in the neutral corner. stomps him down, really laying those boots to the chest. It's Brandon getting a full head of steam, nailing that knee to the face, right across the bridge of the nose of the villain. And he's looking for that slingshot leg drop right across the throat.
He's feeling the effects of that last hit.
Collins, eating the feet right to the face.
Uh-oh. Jarring impact.
Collins swung the momentum of this match around. It's been all him ever since. He's looking to carry that momentum over as he drives those knees into the side of the temple of Casey Heenan.
With these knee strikes.
Yeah, he's got the villain down bad at the moment.
The arm absorbing.
Has him in a stun state too. He can really take advantage of him right here. Puts him on his feet, sets him up for a big fisherman suplex DDT. Oh my god. Brandon showing a mean streak.
This is a great move. The Brainbuster.
Oh, atomic brainbuster right across the knee. One, two. The villain got the shoulder up. He gets the counter. As he drags it into the mat, he is trying to turn the tide back in his favor as he nails that Kamigoye knee to the face. There's a cover. One. Not even a two. Collins popping the shoulder up supremely early. What a springboard moonsault by Casey Heenan. And he's pumped up, folks. So he's got the blood shooting. He's ready to do it. Nailing that diving stomp to the ribs.
Consecutive high-risk maneuvers, and the pace of this match has certainly picked up.
Locks him up. It sends him to the corner. Multiple kicks. Showing his X-Pac kick game off here tonight. And he's trying to have his feet lead him to victory. Nailing another boot to the face in the corner.
The pace of this match now, guys. Yeah, he's
Collins fires back with a kick. This match really getting the pace picked up. There's a running elbow drop.
Blow to the chest.
Fires back with a springboard moonsault of his own. It definitely lands on the mark. As he's looking to hit another handstand headlock.
Nice headlock applied. Look at this athleticism.
The form.
Oh, that was pretty cool.
Unmatched. Here's the cover. That was a very close two count for a headlock. People would have been upset. But he catches that knee to the side of the face. I don't know how much more Casey has left in the tank. Collins is really sizing this man up.
He fends off the attack.
Brandon gets caught lacking. Excuse me. As Heenan nails that nasty strike combo, it ended with a knee to the face. One. Not even a two count. This match rolls on. Casey Heenan looking for that patented brain buster number 8. Rolling through into the cover. Send him up. Heenan, the villain. Guilty as charged. Will it be enough? And Collins got the shoulder of the villain in disbelief.
Unconscious.
Hits the middle rope, misses the moonsault. Here's Collins open, and Kenny capitalized. No, missed a knee drop of his own. Casey outsmarting him, baited him right into it, and then he nails that forearm right off the middle rope. The villain turning up, getting those motorcycle stops to the chest. Grabbing him by the arm, and here comes everybody's favorite move. We call it the breakdown. Multiple kicks followed by locking down that wrist. You grab that free hand, you twerk the wrist all out of position, and then you stand up and drive those knees right to the spot. 2K, get rid of it. Another kick to the back. He's setting him up for that modified crossface. Locks it in right in front of the ropes in front of his escorts here tonight. His partners in tow, Cotter and Cruz. Is he going to tap out?
And watch this. Letting him
free. Oh.
Adam where he wanted
I mean,
him,
I want to call it the crucifixion, but it's too on the nose for me.
Headed to the top now. Take off.
Oh, and it's called the coronation. There you go.
On this match.
Bow! Knee to the elbow. Taking him down.
Oh, that's
just insulting.
What a stomp to the stomach. Collins trying to set up Heenan for it. Oh no, he's got him right in the middle of the ring too.
He may not have a choice.
Can Heenan fight through the pain?
Locked in way too tight. There is no escape.
Connor and Cruz cheering on Collins.
Oh man, that was a thing of beauty. Ready to a snapmare.
Heenan snapmares out of it. Here we go. Stomping out the chest.
And another just non-stop aggression.
Eh. Only because of the T.I.O.N.
Kicks to the lower back.
It is a second breakdown.
Wrist. Just absolutely punishing their opponent here. Relentlessly.
I will rule you. That's my shit.
Oh my God.
Bow.
Wow.
I guess. Yeah, maybe. Oh, what a shoulder breaker. Hold on, hold on. Collins setting up to try to put the villain away. Hold on, hold on. Oh, God, Eddie's stunned too? Bro, just do one more move so he can have some two bars on that resiliency side. Jesus. The neck breaker took him down. And Collins is ready to put this man away. He went for that judo DT, but he absolutely nails that flash of magic, that shining wizard. Will it be enough? Oh, and Heenan popped the shoulder up. No resiliency needed tonight. He's digging down deep.
And look at this now. Bad intentions coming with this.
Something like that. And there's another clutch. Can Heenan fight through the pain? He's got him up high. That's not looking good. And that'll do it.
And that was hard fought.
Wow. Collins fighting it out the hard way, forcing the villain to submission win.
Here's a few
here tonight.
Last match for us.
Oh yeah, because Collins been taking a few L's here and there, but this could definitely put him back where he wants to be. This man's celebration cracks me up every time.
He really displayed his prowess in victory.
With a win like that, he just stood up and commanded the attention of everyone in the WWE Universe.
I think they've noticed, Byron.
Congratulations to Mr. BDE, Brandon Collins, on the big win. He'll be facing Caleb Rivera in the semifinals. Mm-hmm. We moved on to the main event this evening. Woo. It's going to be Kiori Tota taking on the Chinese Nightmare Asia in this one-on-one first round matchup for the Women's Championship Contenders Tournament. The winner of this match will move on to take on Miss T. Yeah. I want Asia to win, but if Kiori wins, I won't be mad at it. She's been taking off lately, and I wouldn't be shocked. You got to remember, Asia came in after that matchup at Tough Love against Karen Marie and absolutely laid the boots to Kiori Tota, bringing us to this first round contest here tonight. Kiori Tota, Asia, Saturday Slugfest, one-on-one. Let's go. The warrior of the land, Kiori Tota, is here. And she's ready for this first round matchup against a newly found rival in Asia. Definite clash of styles. Kiori, the high flyer. Asia, that patented striker. Should be a barn burner. Only time will tell.
This is a match she has long been asking for. She is more than ready to compete tonight.
Yeah. Let's get it.
And it's almost time to start.
This woman made her debut at the Jackpot Rumble, coming in at the lucky number 30 slot. Which turned out to be unlucky as she had a big target on her back.
She is physically
got double teamed multiple times by Carmine Day and Rachel Romero before ultimately being tossed out. She's looking to build her way up through the division the hard way here in this championship contenders tournament. Let's get it. Tota, Asia, Saturday Slugfest, one-on-one, ring that bell.
She's a woman on a mission. She has the singular goal of being the most dominant superstar in the women's division.
Asia locks up early, sends her right into the referee. Ref, get out the way before you get fired.
She doesn't care who she has to run over. There is no second place for her in any
competition. Dropping Kyoi with that neck breaker. That's the same maneuver that brought her victory in her match against Myers Briggs, which placed her in this division in the first place.
In this fight,
Fireman's carry.
Nice takedown.
Kyoi heading to the top early. Looking for a moonsault super early, and she nails it. Right into a cover.
And into the count. Two. She just kicks out.
Just the slightest bit of hesitation.
What a close two count.
The difference there.
Taking her by
missed
surprise. Went for another moonsault, found nothing but the mat. She
being
misdirected that alignment.
Right,
she almost had to pay for it. Getting that snake eyes on Asia. She looks to send her to the outside.
And a
drop kick finds its mark, and Asia goes crashing to the floor.
She slips outside. What has she got in mind?
Went for the falling knee drop. Asia rolled out of the way. And she locks her up with this kick combo. Nailing that elbow to the face and a big knee to the side of the temple.
Oh, yeah. She is really showing her confidence.
It cracks me up every time the referee holds somebody back. What a combo. And those knees to the gut. Okay.
Knee strikes.
Quick thinking.
Kyoi fired back with a kick of her own. Showing she can strike with the best of them. She nails that single arm DDT. Asia yanks her right into the mat. What a moonsault.
Down on the opponent. She's starting to look concerned.
Got her by the wrist. There's a Kamigoye knee. Looks for the cover.
Is it enough? Two count.
I just be throwing some names out here and there. I had some names and I completely forgot them, so now I'm just flying by the pants. I remember that one. Kyoi off the middle rope, went for that cross body. Asia with a counter, missed the kick, and they're back at square one.
Targeting the arm to great effect.
Big German suplex.
Her shoulders are down.
Well, Marcus drives me nuts.
Yeah. Well, if you still can't get more than a one count by now.
Eventually, I'm gonna name them and have official names.
Neck breaker. Top rope. Here we go.
Real stick. Kyoi on the top. Looking for another moon salt. Oh my God! Right across the ribs. One, two. No. Asia fighting through that aerial assault to get that left shoulder up. Kyoi continuing the high flying antics. Getting real flippy floppy with her. Big kick. Looking for that knee assistant on Enziguri to the face.
She's going up.
Top rope here.
Oh yeah. Oh Lord. She wants to go for that red arrow, but Asia's laying face first. Had it scouted, but she gets caught with an elbow drop for her trouble.
She finds herself only playing defense.
Yeah, she keeps getting cut down at the
pass. That's smart. See, if she stays down like that, she can't go for that red arrow because she wants to go right into the cover. So Asia really toying with Kyoi here tonight as she stirs up to get to her feet. Kyoi locking her up with that wrist clutch, Northern Lights suplex. Turns her back over and there's a cover. Is it enough? One, two. No.
Somehow she
pops up the shoulder. Here we go.
It's unbelievable.
Ooh, got her by the arm. Was looking for a DDT. And there's an arm wrench monkey flip. Shades of Young Bundy.
She's fighting hard and it is paying off. Holding in on the arm.
Oh, Lord. Max sending me stuff after midnight. This better not be bad. Ugh. Flipping neck breaker. Kiori to the top rope looking for that red arrow. Absolutely nails it. Wow. Two. Asia got the shoulder up. Kiori can't believe it. And Asia's going to have to get this one out the mud as her resiliency has been spent. She's got to rebuild that momentum the hard way. Hits the middle rope. Big flying forearm to the face. A nasty kick to the spine. Here we go.
After what we've seen so far, you
Asia
question the
turns her out, dropping her face first across the knee. My boy Mac. Fist to the face.
One after another.
Usually, if he sends something after midnight, something bad happens. Or there's a crazy sale or some breaking wrestling news. Leg drop across the arm. And this is Asia's chance to capitalize right here. On the top rope. Wait for her to get to her feet. Here we go. Big elbow. Jesus.
She now has gotten herself into a distressing spot.
She just has a fight.
She's really picked up the pace here. Yeah. Dustin or go cards. That's probably what you recognize it as. But that's Matt. And it stops him in the ribs. Stops her in the ribs. Woo! That was a close two count. Too close for comfort for me.
Are you sure that's two?
Asia really fighting back here tonight.
Oh no! Now
oh, she's going for that modified cross face. Excuse me. Locks her up in the center of the ring. Nowhere for Kiori to go. She's got to fight through this pain here tonight.
Can she hang on? Can she somehow hang on?
She will not quit.
Breaks free of the hold. Get that elbow up. And both women back on their feet. Taking her off from taking her on her back with the drop. There's another moonsault. Excuse me. Here we go. Arm wrench, monkey flip. More shades of Young Bundy, and Kiori is feeling it here tonight. She's trying to go for another pin attempt. Lord.
She's going.
Will the monkey flip be enough? One, two, no.
Competitors digging deep into their
Asia getting the shoulder up once again, gets caught with a kick to the face. And there's a drop kick to the spine. Kiori, high risk, high reward on the top row. Big tadpole splash.
Continues to attack with aggression.
Jesus.
As this match goes on.
That's saying so.
Oh, the kick she never saw coming.
Is out of her
Asia back on her feet. Trying to lock up Tota.
I got a feeling somebody.
Look at that. X-plex. There's a cover. One. Two. Woo. And Tota getting the shoulder. This match is getting nuts, folks.
They didn't even know existed.
Look at that arm wrench. Running arm drag. Ugh. Asia on the top rope. Ready to put her away. Looking for that padded double rotation moonsault. Oh!
Wow.
God!
Wow.
One. Two. No! Kiori got the shoulder up. Wow. Wow, oh wow. This match continuing. Oh.
To feel the agony of defeat is causing this never surrender attitude.
Jawbreaker.
Shot was thrown, but it couldn't put this match away.
She took her signatures from me. Oh, she was going for that one. Because she's got this. Whoa! Both women going for double springboards, but Kiori on the advantage. Going for that tilt-a-whirl head scissors. Takes her off her feet. There's another cover.
She kicks out with
and she got the shoulder up. That was nuts.
This is unreal. She's going up.
And she's looking to end it all. Looking for that red arrow. Got the knees up. Wow. Right into a cover. One. Two. Oh. And Kiori with the shoulder up. What a match. Ooh, this is getting good.
Truly awesome. Oh, foot just stomping.
Asia, try to rebuild that momentum. Mm-hmm. I don't know how they would have landed, but I was ready to find out. Motorcycle stomps to the chest.
Multiple stomps.
What a knee to the ribs. Kiori ducking the chop. High kick. More elbows. Asia can't get her hands up. She looks for the springboard. Gets nothing. Asia looking to capitalize on the opening. Sets her up for that knee to the elbow. Locks Kiori up once again. Has her in the fallaway position. Takes her to the corner. She ragdolls her right into the middle of the ring. She's stunned. This is her chance. Asia playing up to the crowd. She can't showboat here. She's got to stay focused. Returns her attention back to Kiori. And there's another stomp right across that elbow. Dropping the knee into the right arm. There's a cover. One, two. Woo. Tota digging down deep. Got the left shoulder up. What's Asia got to do to put her away? She's going right back to that arm. She's trying to set up for the submission. Only time will tell. She lands these multiple knees to the chest. It's anyone's ball game from here, folks.
Carefully.
What a high knee. Springboard finding its mark. They are going at it. What a counter kick. Kiori off the middle rope. What a moonsault to the spine. Jesus. And Kiori's got her into submission. Can Asia hang on? She's fighting it. She's fighting as hard as she can.
She's squeezing for dear life.
Not sure why, but
she slams her face first and goes for the cover. One, two. No. Yeah. This is the one. This is the one. Tota and Asia back on their feet. Step up, Inzaguri kick to the face. Kiori on the top, but she's laying face first. Asia's got this woman's finisher scouted. Playing the mind games. Refusing to move. Goes for the elbow and nails it.
Climbing up to the top now.
Doubling down on the elbow drops. Kiori is pissed. Thinks about it. And there's another one. Is that all? One, two, and she got the shoulder up. What is happening?
We all thought that was it.
Kiori told her ready to risk it all. Finally has a setup for that red arrow.
Forget it. She's
one, two, three. What a match. Holy shit.
This superstar picks up a huge victory here tonight. Much deserved, Michael.
There might be. It might not be. That was a match. That was a matchy match. One of the best first rounders I've seen across the singles tournament so far. And we didn't even get to the women's IC yet. But your winner here tonight, Kiori Tota, picking up the big dub on Slugfest. She'll be moving on to week 43 to take on Miss T in the semifinals. As we know, our semifinals matchups across the women's championship and men's championship tournaments. It's going to be Hip Hop Jove taking on Bulldozer, Caleb Rivera taking on Brandon Collins, Bertha taking on Jackie Rivera, and Miss T taking on Kiori Tota. It's going to be an interesting one indeed. I'd like to thank everybody for joining this stream. Hope you had a good time. Oh, and don't forget, Connor taking on Rodney That Dude, and Chris Cole taking on Lunchbox in the semifinals of the IC Championship Contenders Tournament. Those are going to be fire. Thanks for coming through. Peace, love, soul. Good night.